Okay, today I'm going to be comparing two vintage Simplex horn strobes. So both of these are from the 2903 series, which was produced from probably around 1979 to I think the early 90s. The one on the left is quite a bit older than the one on the right. Might have been even the original revision. So now we're going to take a look inside and see the differences. Move these back boxes out of the way. Okay, so you can see the one on the right, that's the strobe circuitry most of you fire alarm enthusiasts are familiar with. It's got the little potentiometer for controlling the flash speed, a bunch of other fancy stuff. I think this thing back here is actually a secondary strobe tube for some reason. And here's the one on the left. You can see there's actually it's much wider, so it uses these outer screw holes or whatever, screw receptacles. I don't know what the proper term is. So it's a great deal wider, and it lacks the potentiometer found on the newer model. So both of them, if you could see right, I don't know if you could see right here, are labeled as being 70 milliamps. So according to like the documentation, they both draw the same amount of current. However, this one, the one on the left, the older one, flashes much faster and is much brighter. So I don't know if that's entirely accurate. If it is, I don't know why they didn't just stick with this one. But anyway, I guess we could go into a little bit of detail about the horns on these two. So the one here is a Simplex 2901-9806. Here is a 2901-9833. The 9806 is a relabeled Federal vibratone horn, model 450. And this one is a relabeled Faraday 6020. So they have slightly different sounds. This one has more of like an air horn sound. Sounds at about an E note. This one sounds at about a C note and has a more metallic, brassy sound. All right, so now, without further ado, let's get to the test.